So I got the 550 for just for now. Usually my dad likes to run this truck. This is like the best truck that we got as far as for plowing anyways. It's just super comfortable. It's central hydraulics, tailgate salter. You can put about 5 ton in here, stainless box. It's super nice. It's a short truck, single cab, so it's just ideal for the commercial lots and stuff we do. It's perfect to be able to hold this much salt and everything. But so anyways, I'm using this one because when all the cars are in these lots, it's a little bit easier to maneuver through all the lanes and stuff rather than that big international that I usually would drive. So plus with all the cars in the way, my 5 ton should go a long ways. And then tonight we'll come in there and clean everything up in between the cars and all that stuff and salt it all up. Alright, so we're gonna plow some of this stuff. Get some of this opened up here. Get these loading docks open right away for the trucks. It's actually pretty slick underneath here.
Somebody once told me the world is gonna roll me. I ain't the sharpest tool in the shed. She was looking kind of dumb with her finger and her thumb in the shape of an L on her forehead. Well, the years start coming and they don't stop coming. Fed to the rules and I hit the ground running. Didn't make sense not to live for fun. Your brain gets smart but your head gets dumb. So much to do, so much to see. So what's wrong with taking the back streets? You'll never know if you don't go. You'll never shine if you don't glow. Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play. Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get paid.
Jose, how are you doing?
Good, yourself?
Good. Is it snowing over there?
Yeah, it's snowing.
Is it kind of like a dust snow? Yeah. Okay, because I'm in North Prairie and I'm plowing stuff right now. So I haven't been in Waukesha yet. I was just seeing if there's any snow on by the road or if it's.
It looks like it, but you know, it's real.
I'll call you in about another hour maybe and we'll see if it's snowing, because it's snowing pretty heavy over here and I think it's coming your way.
Okay,
so be ready. I'll probably have you go to that machine in a little bit.
All right. Let me know.
Okay, sounds good. Thank you.
Sure.
Bye. Morning, Greg.
Morning, bud.
You want to work for a little bit?
Yeah, I told your dad I could help you.
Yeah, Well, you can take my pickup is in there, or else if you want to run that other truck, but you, I would run my pickup if I was you.
The white one?
Yeah, rather than that little dump truck. It's shorter. It's easier to, a little bit easier to move around or whatever.
Okay, what time are you thinking?
Right now.
Oh, okay, what are we doing first?
Well, I'm over here in North Prairie right now. I'm plowing this stuff right now.
Where do you want me to head when I get in?
I guess you can do, maybe do downtown right away.
Elsman?
Yeah. Or, well, maybe we let that wait. You can come over here in North Prairie, do water company, and do,
a bottling company?
Yeah, and Union House and stuff will do one time. It looks like on the radar, it looks like there's this first band, and then there might be a break.
Right, and it's
going to
come in again for the rest of the day.
Then. Right, then it looks heavier later, yeah.
Okay, well, I'll get ready here, and then I'll give you a call when I...
Okay, you'll have to go get some salt in that truck, though.
Oh, okay. All right.
I got the machine plugged in. Arrow's already up there.
Okay, buddy.
All right, thanks, Greg.
Yeah, bye.
Bye. All right, so I got Jose on call kind of right now. I got Greg coming in. I'm just getting this area. This is where the trucks come in right away. I'm thinking I'm gonna go get that loader started up here really quick because gonna be much quicker for me. I can get some salt down and
opportunity to seize everything you ever wanted in one moment that you captured, just let it slip.
So I'm getting this salted up really heavy for this trucking lane that goes through here. Keep these loading docks really good so that they can see when they're backing in, see their lines. It's nice that it's 32 degrees still. Let the salt work really good. I always do it really heavy because obviously all this is going to drain down, so do the top side heavy and it should be good.
A little bit, huh?
Yeah.
I'm gonna get those other ones salted up then, you can get these lanes cleaned up. And
yeah,
then,
I start obviously here, so I head back.
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, clean it up again, and I'll get those salted up nice. How you been?
Good. Yourself?
Good.
Good.
Yeah. Hopefully, I don't know, we'll see if we'll get some more. They say next week maybe some more snow.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh.
I'm ready for the weather, warm weather, though. Ready to go back to work. All right, everyone, it's 12:30 now. Still like 32 degrees out. Salt is holding everything off very well. So probably won't have to come back out even until, probably not until tonight if everything holds off good. So just pick me up some Culver's here. Working my way back towards Dallasman. I gotta help Greg out with one more little place downtown Dallasman, and then that is it for this morning. So we'll see if it picks back up this afternoon or what. I haven't looked at the radar in a little bit, but sort of seems like it's kind of fading out here now. And like I say, salt is holding everything off good. So I'll see you guys later when we go back out tonight and clean everything up. Hey everyone, so it's about 2:30. I'm heading back out here to just make sure everything is good for everybody on their way home tonight when they leave work. Make sure everyone can get out decent. I gotta stop and pick me up a better shovel from the shop real quick. And then I gotta check sidewalks at this one restaurant that we do. I think they open up at 4 o'clock or something, 3 o'clock, the workers start getting there, I think. So get those sidewalks cleaned up real fast. Go check our commercials, make sure everyone else can get out. So we'll go do that. We got, I don't know, maybe there's a couple inches now. But like I say, the salt has been working really well today. So it's still, my truck still says 29 degrees now, so it's still pretty warm. But it's supposed to drop fast tonight.
Mama don't pray for my success anymore. Yeah, but mama still prays for me.
Say there's another 1 to 3 on the way. We probably got about 3 to 4, maybe like isolated 5 in some areas. So we're out just getting everything cleaned up for everyone to go home. And then we're gonna go back out about 9 o'clock or so when it's wrapping up, get everything cleaned up, salted really nice. So I'm just in Waukesha right now and just making my way over by Jose. Check on him again, and then throw some salt over there, and then that'll do it for the evening. And then, over, like I say, we'll go back out about 9 o'clock. About 10:30. No, 10 o'clock. Yeah, 10 o'clock. They got Andy going over there, and then I went and did a couple driveways for some people, and then the one driveway though. Almost got stuck in that thing. I didn't even finish it. I told my buddy or whatever, he helps us sometimes plowing. I told him, I said, you're gonna have to get your skid loader and do it yourself. I almost slid like sideways down that thing. It was so icy underneath, and then it hasn't been done all day, so there's a good 6 inches on it, drifted over and everything. And it's on a hill that's just straight up, and this 550 is not the best for driveways. So I told him he's gonna have to just snow blow it or something. I don't know, or do it with a skid loader. But I'm not getting stuck here at the beginning of the night like that. Not starting with that. So I did one other little place as well, that restaurant again. So we're off to a decent start. I gotta head to Pewaukee now. I talked to Jose. He is doing good. He's got one place already done out there, so hopefully Pewaukee ain't too bad. But I have a feeling I got a couple hours out there. And then gotta salt everything up coming back through. Might have to go get another load, not sure. We'll see. It's already down to 20, so I don't know. See what happens. I also need to stop and get me a snack. I ate dinner and took like a little power nap. I had like an hour or so, hour and a half. A little 259, just moving some snow. You guys, so this is probably gonna wrap up this video. I got probably another 2 to 3 hours, I would say. I'm gonna go through and salt everything else, and then probably end up helping Andy out over in North Prairie. There's a lot of snow over there, a lot of drifting and stuff, so we'll see. Maybe I'll get some more video, but I'm kind of getting tired. Been up since like 6 o'clock this morning. All right, everyone, I'm gonna end this video with this time lapse here. I was getting really tired that night. I didn't have much sleep at all during the day or anything like that. And it was just getting to me towards the end there. So I think we got done around like 3:30, 4 o'clock that morning. I had to go back and get another load of salt and stuff. I think this lot actually only took me like an hour, which is really surprising. There's about 5-6 inches on the whole thing, maybe more in some areas where it had drifted. But in total, I think we got like 5 or 6 inches everywhere. So it ended up being a really good storm. But I'll leave you guys to watch the rest of this time lapse. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. And I hope to have some more coming out soon here. So thanks for watching, everyone.